Hello, hello, you beautiful people, and welcome back to another episode of the TORQUAY United Career Mode. Our road to glory, we're doing it in style in our second ever season.
And where we left things off, we're just outside the playoffs.
But the real question is, will we be in the playoffs by the end of the season? Because I think that's just been my sole goal. And, well, it's a bit of a 50-50, to be honest with you, because looking at the squad, it looks pretty decent. But the same problem just keeps coming back and back again. What's that problem, you may be asking? We can't bloody score again! Yeah, the montage is back, but the reason is valid. We just can't get the goals up forward, especially against that Exeter game last episode. We were trying so badly, but efforts were going absolutely nowhere. Even though it is January, we've still got that debt in there, but I did see some free agents that could make a real impact for me. And that is including this player, because to be honest with you, I've only got one left back. So Kevin Brocu will be joining the squad, followed up by someone I know will be a good impact in the attack and forwards. Yep, experienced player he is, Bradley Dack will be joining TORQUAY United. And we did manage to reduce the debt. We sold someone for the biggest transfer fee, one of our own, Holt, for 800k, which literally reduced the deficit by quite a lot. But we were down a winger, and I did find this American for free agents, Ulysses Laz Jr. Okay, to be honest with you, I'm quite happy with the squad. To be honest with you, the good players coming in. Oh, sorry, I've got myself an email. No, what's it? Crap. Come on, Leeds. Come on. There it is, Leeds United. There he is, Joseph. Come on, get him on another loan.
Denied.
All right, since the fact I can't get Joseph, I decided to go for another loan striker. And this one's got experience in League One. Troy Parrott, the Irishman, joins for a loan deal for the rest of the season. Okay, after that little panic, I think Troy Parrott would be a decent thing, and maybe deja vu may repeat ourselves, because we've got two new attacking players. They could help us out in getting into the playoffs, or staying in there, or maybe more. Who knows? But we're going to start with that with the match highlights. And of course, I got to kick things off with the Devon derby against Plymouth Argyle at home. And Bradley Dack was going to really steal the show for us, but it just sadly got saved. But the real scary thing is Plymouth at home, because they could be really threatening at home, especially, well, you can see right there, Morgan Whittaker of all players, their star man, gets the opening goal, something unlike what happened at the start of the season. So then I decided to think it, alright, maybe I'll mark one of their players, specifically Ryan Hardy. Nope, that didn't work at all. Alright then, if I can't mark him, how about I injure them? Fouled him, but that turns out to be a bigger mistake, as Ryan Hardy went on to complete the brace and lose him 3-0 in our opening game. Then we move on to Shrewsbury Town away. Parrott, on the other hand, was on a mission. Tom Cruise would be impressed with it, but only hits the post. Then afterwards, Kane went for another one, but it just got saved. So I decided to bring in a sledgehammer as Troy Parrott laid it across to Bradley Dack. The birds of prey connected well and get the first goal. Don't worry, Troy Parrott was able to get his goal for it as he slots it past the goalkeeper to make it 2-0. But it didn't help that much that Shrewsbury were able to pull one back. Because later in the second half, a cross came in, unmarked man, near post, and Jordan Arch couldn't even save it. And with the comeback train on Shrewsbury Town, well, it was only a matter of time before they completed that compact and losing 3-2. With two losses on my track already, first place Sheffield Wednesday will be quite a much difficult team. And fever pitch was going round as one mistake from Arbor, and oh god, that could have been absolutely diabolical. But then it was our turn. Troy Parrott played it across the list. And the Kiwi was able to get an unspectable goal against first place Sheffield Wednesday. And Bradley Dack wants a piece of that pie. But only thing he could hit was the bloody post. Until wrapped it things up, the Kiwi himself makes it 2-0 with a great win against Sheffield Wednesday. But at Portsmouth at home and playing more, we've got a lost Parry and List due to international duty. So the pressure was on, but Jackson wanted to prove that he was still a threat up forward. Literally getting in Mr. Hawk's good books, but save from Macy was keeping him out of it. But soon afterwards, Portsmouth's bags, well, just like in the Premier League days, absolutely burst and gone into administration, just like us. As Carey was able to get a tap in. And yes, all the hard work did play off for Jackson, as he did connect a two. And well, after that, things kind of went out of hand.
On to the debt derby now, as we've got Reading. As both of us are in familiar shoes, it wasn't long for Just to get into a new familiar with Parrott instead of Joseph, as he was able to set up for Parrott's goal. But Parrott, he wasn't just intent of getting the first goal, as he was on the verge of getting a hat-trick. But we've had these chances before, with so many, but afterwards they snatch one in the end. But thanks to the Scotsman Jordan Archer, he was able to keep them at bay. And Parrott getting frustrated not getting a goal, he did produce the assist, and over the top to Josh Murphy, who did put the second past Reading. And even though they did manage to pull one back, I didn't really care, because even though I was complaining of the lack of goals, boy, there were plenty of goals in this game. And well, let's just say Reading, well, the bills were piling up. I got bills, I gotta pay. So we leave League One on the shelf for now and move on to the EFL trophy, or the Bristol Street Motor Trophy, whatever the trophy is called these days. It's Notts County and a trip to Wembley. Even though I rotate the whole entire squad, Pritchard had the golden chance of them all, but missed it completely. But we produced rapid fire, and it was not enough for Notts County to contain, as a corner came in for Grievous, who connected with the header. But Notts County, they wanted a quick response, as well as that revenge, and a 1-2 was enough to make it 1-1 for them. But our response was quicker, especially if you got Jackson in your team out of all players. The pace of the guy was enough to deny Notts County of getting their sweet revenge. And just going in before the halftime, I was looking good 2-1, until Randall made it 2-2. But that didn't really affect us out, because we came out the bigger swingers. But at what cost? Because even though Jackson's gone, he did have to come off it. Pritchard, get off the guy, he's hurt already! Even though losing the striker did hurt us, it didn't hurt us much more when you got Landstaff getting an equaliser, then followed up from retirement castle David McGoldbridge, making it look like they're going to go to Wembley this time. A trip to Wembley and a trophy on stake right here, we decided to go for it. I even brought on a young talent, Yang Bailey, who could have become their hero right here, but he just hits the post. As the clocks just kept on ticking, it went to Junior, it got saved, and Bailey from the open net hits the crossbar and in.
Hey, hey, Bailey, ooh, ah, I wanna know if you be my guy.
Oh, he made it 4-4, and that resorted to a penalty shootout clash with Wembley on the line, and Jordan Archer, the veteran goalkeeper, denying County, and afterwards securing Torquay United to another trip to Wembley in a cup finals. That's ending the match highlights here. Let's go to the live games.
So we're going to kick things off with the Pizza Trophy that itself, or Bristol City Motor Trophy, or St. Johnston Paint Trophy, whatever name of this EFL trophy, we've got a finals. It's going to be against Peterborough United. It's return trip to Wembley. This time, last year, we were in the playoff finals. Now, we're fighting for a trophy, and it could have Torquay's name on it. So we're going to kick things off right away. Come on, you girls.
All right, we're going to pass it 1-2, Burrows. Now, I know Peterborough have got really good players, and to be fair, this is going to be quite a hard game for us. But you know what? We're here. Wembley Collins, straight on Archer. Oof, all right, a little bit of a warning right there, but we're going to play it long into ball. Literally the best person on the ball, Pans Galore. Oh, God, just called myself a comedian. Bradley Dack now. Can he find someone? He found Josh Murphy. Lovely work, brilliant work. Could he get the finish? It touches! It's 1-0! It's a brilliant start for, oh yes, the goals, Torquay United. It's great for a kick-off. Well, the early chance, the only chance for Torquay, and it's 1-0. Okay, Peterborough United. Get a kick off from the spot. 1-0. Get in there. To be fair, what was the score against Bradford? 2-1. We were losing quite early on. So getting this first chance really does set the template of the match. And, well, it can really set how good our defence is. Because you can see Peterborough United on the attack. All right, let's see. Lovely work from them. Plays a good pass in. Randall couldn't get it to tackle. Good chance. It's 1-1. There goes our lead. Up in smokes as Peterborough United respond with a quick equaliser. Randall controls the ball. Plays a lovely ball in. Lovely work from them. My God, they've got mad skills on the ball. I'll tell you that. Lovely work right here. Collins twist round. Free kick advantage into Clark Harris. Good save from Archer. Okay. Can we just play it a little bit easy now? Glover plays it across to Kane. Kane trying to hold it across into Brown. Brown, heavy touch. It's too heavy. It's 1-1. Peterborough got a golden chance to take the lead at Wembley, and they have. Oh, such a heavy touch from Brown. And it really, really did bite me where it hurts. Josh Murphy, let's get him on. Quick response. It's not our first time trailing at Wembley. And it hopefully won't be our last. Just lovely chance for the Kiwi to restore our lead. It's off. It's straight in the feet of Graham Carey. Short ball. Take two. It's in the back of the net for an equaliser. Graham Carey. Who else, folks? The Irish legend. Freaking get in there. Clark Harris plays it across. All they're doing is pressurising me in the box. Graham Carey's already on a yellow card. Could come back. Oh, no. He's giving away the ball. That's unlike him at all. Plays it across now. Could the Peterborough get the chance of getting the lead? They're playing it back. Trying to open up for a mistake on my hand. It's going to happen soon. Oh, plays it 1-2. Collins sees the chance. 1-2. No, come on. Tackle. No, that tackle failed badly. Back into Collins. It's gone in. It's 3-2 just before the half. Real heartbreaking stuff as Peterborough have gotten back their lead. And we can see from the wing, Peterborough now going to edge in my box again. This is what they got the first goal from. They put piling pressure in me. So I'm going to break. Kane through balls it to Justice. We managed to win the ball right here. The Kiwi plays it to Bradley Dack. Trying to find the run of the Parrot. He passes it to his bird of prey tag team partner for the finishing combo. Yes, Troy Parrot gets in there. I'm not going to lie, he's been a lot better signed than Charlie McHale, whatever the hell his name is. But the real name of the story of Torquay United is Troy Parrott, as he's got us back level.
All right, we can see Peterborough going on the attack, and it's been so good up forward. Nothing much I could really do about that. Oh, I won the ball lovely right here. Bradley Dack plays a lovely ball into Kane. Kane winnes it through. Through balls it into the Kiwi. Eliza just goes through. Got to be. Come on, sweats it across to Troy Parrott. It's 4-3, and the first time I get to say this, Torquay United have taken the lead at Wembley.
Good work from him right here. 1-2, Collins. Come on, good tackle from Kane. Come on. Trying to see. Over the top through ball. Troy Parrott on the verge for a hat-trick at Wembley. Something he'll remember for the rest of his life. As we've doubled our lead, Troy Parrott gets off to a brilliant start in a Torquay United shirt. A hat-trick at Wembley.
Through balls now to Clark Harris, who's trying his best to get some hope here for Peterborough United for the posh.
Through balls. It's got to be. It's a great save from Jordan Arch. Lovely header from Brown to get it away from the danger zone. As Elijah adjusts right here. Good work from him.
And we'll get a good run right here. And I can see a lovely lot of room for Troy Parrott, who slays it across,
return the favour as Bradley Dack was able to put pretty much, I'm going to say it, the final coffin in Peterborough United's trophy.
Goals galore here at Wembley, 9 goals. Freaking hell, we might be breaking some kind of record, I'd tell you that. As well, they're going to go for a lovely chance of themselves. As, yeah, oh, bloody hell, it was not a bad tackle. To be fair, it was on the edge of the wing, I can't really do nothing about it. I didn't want to get in the zone. To be honest with you, I think there's far point from going on to that.
Oh, bloody hell, he's been sent off, Glover. Well, another tryst and pretty much chaotic trip at Wembley. Goals galore and a red card to add things on.
I had to take Bradley Dack off just so I can be able to do something right here. As Kane through balls it into Just right here. Lovely chance. Good. Oh, I was going to say, in the real hero. Come on, Carey tried to win that ball. 81st minute. He's won the ball. Graham Carey charging his way through goal, plays the assist to his Irish companion, and Troy Parrott is onto goal fiesta, the final one, the tale for Peterborough United as the full-time whistle goes. We've done it again at Wembley, undefeated, the streak still alive, as we managed to pick up a trophy on our road to glory trails. Yes, that is the Bristol City motor. Oh, you know, just the EFL trophy. We've done it. Get in. Okay, looking at the final table of League One, we did set ourselves in a comfortable 6th place finish, which means that we are going to be in the playoffs in League One. To be honest with you, with the help of Troy Parrott and our new signings, we did be able to creep over the line, get the goals which was needed, and secure playoffs for the goals. Who have we got? Sheffield United, which this time in January, they're first place and they dropped to third. So what I'm going to do, like I did against Notts County, sim it and 2-2. You know what? That's a fair result. So we're going to go into the second leg with a lot on the line, a potential promotion to the Championship against Sheffield Wednesday. Let's bloody do it, girls. Come on, heads it down. Lovely Troy Parrott. Through balls it into Eliza Just. Got so much room now on him. Anything could be on the line right here with Wembley at stake. Dak through balls it. Graham Carey goes for it. Dreadful shot from the Irishman. Through balls it. Smith, lovely ball again. Come on. Oh, bloody hell. Too many chances as Felwo now tries to cross it in. It's an open header. And just for the skin of my teeth right here, how on earth did he miss that? Here we go, Sheffield Wednesday. The Owls versus the Gulls. I know I'll put my money on if it was an actual bird fight right here. But, oh, bloody hell, they're going to go for it just before. No, good tackle for Glover. Great save from Jordan Arch, though, as he's absolutely irate. I wouldn't piss off a Scotsman. That's not on my to-do list anytime soon. But what I need to do right now is deal with this bloody corner. That's more pressure from Bannermer. Heads it, Jordan Archer. Again with another brilliant save. The Owls are getting absolutely frustrated, I'll tell you that now. Another corner for him right here. It's going to be whipped in. Third time, heads it down. Rebound, Jordan Archer saves it again. How? Literally, he's been such a great keeper for me. Oh, God. Sorry, I'm just trying to catch my breath at the moment because I've just been on an onslaught from the Owls. And now, just before the half, can we deliver a vital blow? Bradley Dack into Kane. Through balls at lovely work from Troy Parrott as he does the defenders. Slotted bottom corner. And against the run of play, TORQUAY United take the lead over Sheffield Wednesday. They seemed like they were going to grab the first goal, but nope. We snatched it out of their hands as Troy Parrott delivers the killer blow. Murphy, good work from him. Through balls into Troy Parrott. Now, let's lays it across to Kane. Kane goes for it. What a save from Charles as Kane could have really helped our chances. Free kick right here, and I'm going to go for it, Graham Carey. You know, when it comes to him and free kicks, he is absolutely the bloody goat. So let's just see. Just get my finger out, test the wind. Going to go for the shot. Deflected off the first man. Disappointed on that. Kane lays it back to Graham Carey. Whips it in. Josh Murphy! Bloody hell. If that was on target, I'll be singing myself to Wembley. Bannerman. Through balls. He's still playing for Wednesday? Yeah, typical. Right here, it's 85th minute. All on the line for Sheffield Wednesday, the Owls. As now we're going to catch him on the counter-attack. From the American Junior. Lovely work. Through balls into Graham Carey. Could he return the favour? But no, he just keeps on running right here. 1-2 passes. Troy Parrott. Onside delivers the final blow to Sheffield Wednesday and secures another trip to Wembley. My God, just call us Wembley season ticket holders. We've got the final ball over the back of the net, ending Sheffield United's chance of getting promoted as TORQUAY United going to Wembley. Here it is, our final game. Charlton Athletic, Wembley, Championship in only back-to-back season. And yet we could bloody do it. All we got to take on is the Addicts. And everything is on the stakes. Especially Vince, Mr. Hawk's former side, a familiar face. I can't underestimate them, but they can't underestimate us either. As this is the biggest game in TORQUAY United's history. Here we go, Coventry as the old good tackle right here. It's going to be through chance. Come on, over the top through ball. Josh Murphy. Able to outpace him, he's got a defender on him. Lays it across to Troy Parrott. Does all the work, goes for sure. It's a good save from Maynard. But Josh Murphy keeps the chance alive. It's hot and steamy, folks. It's into Kane. Lovely pass. Eliza Just, 1-0. Gets in there, just like Peterborough United. We the strike when the iron is hot. Free kick, dangerous area. Good chance to whip it in. They did. headed down by Kane. Troy Parrott on the ball. Let's get him on the counter-attack right here. Try and find the pass. Does it in. Lovely work from Bradley Dack. Oh, good work. This is better. It's 1-on-1. A golden chance to make it 2. I went for the assist. I should have went for bloody goal. Too much thinking of it as Maynard. Lovely goal kick. It's headed down. Kane, terrible pass though. As now, they're going to get us again on the free kick. Oh, not free kick. Free chance right here. And now Cox now. Come on, tackled. Come on. What? A free kick for what? Literally, I was trying to worry about the defending right here. As now they did literally have a free kick. Oh my bloody word! What a goal! A stunning response from the Addicts. As an absolute spectacular free kick in the League One player finals, meaning it's all square. I'm just going to admire this goal. What a beauty. Kane heads it down to Josh Murphy. Good work from him right here. Through balls it into Graham Carey. Come on, the work, the determination. Back to Josh Murphy. Through balls it. It's into Kane. And going for a power shot. Oh my bloody God, Maynard. Barely got that away. What a save from him. And now we can see Jones 1-2 passing. Now Coventry, no, not Coventry, literally, they've got a player called Coventry, but Charlton Athletic have been an absolute threat for us as Taylor through balls, it's into May. May not be a good chance right here, maybe worse, as that player, Coventry, that's the one I'm worried about the most. 1-2 passing, Coventry gets the shot off, saved. Oh my God, we're getting close. Not the person I want to pass to, bad timing, bad disaster. Oh, bloody hell, 2-1. Well, that reminds me of, it reminded me when Charlton scored that goal against Sunderland, that own goal. Oh, absolute disaster at Wembley. Chaos, mayhem, and more. Through Bald into Cox. Now, 1-2, Coventry. Oh, bloody hell, this is going to get worse, especially just before the half. May, good chance to double the lead, but Archer saved. Come on, tackled. Nope, not work. Good work from Dominic, even though he did cost us that lead, or cost us the goal. He's still doing well. Come on, good work from Bradley Dapp. Through balls, it's another one touch into Josh Murphy. Get us back on track, and he does. 2-2, good response in the second half from the goals. Dawson, I want to say. Oh, how can I forget about him? He scored that banger of a free kick, Riviers. Now, oh, good pressure. Kane, through balls, it into Elijah Just. Just the moment I need. There we go, over the top. Lovely work from Troy Parrott. Double on lead. Oh! You can't say it's not pressure because he freaking scored a hat-trick last time he was here. But that shot was dreadful, just wide and all. And we can see May plays it across. I tell you what, nearly 60 minutes in and no team is looking like they're going to back down. They both want the promised land of going to the championship. May, lovely turn from him, back into Riviera's and Jordan Archer with a great save. I tell you that, fuming from him. They want to take their lead back, and to be fair, with this corner, it could be a golden chance as Coventry could be the man. Could he deliver the ball? It's going to be whipped in. Josh Murphy only heads it backwards, and Taylor, oh my God, he gave us the freaking equaliser. Then afterwards, on at the other end, and nearly gave Charlton a goal. Kane through, but oh, bloody hell. Can't make these mistakes at Wembley, I'll tell you that. OLO reduces the mistake right here. Kane leading the charge. Over the top through ball into Eliza Just. I see Josh Murphy cross it in, first time effort, and it's bottom corner for Torquay United, giving us the lead in one of the biggest games of the season. Josh Murphy at it again, get in there.
You can see through balls it into Coventry, 1-2 passing, Adun, no, oh bloody hell, I'm just so relieved that we've got this lead, can't let him take the shot, oh,
fudge stickles. Oh, that's a definite pen. Definite pen. Yellow card for Glover. Oh, he got sent off last time he was here. Now he's costing us a bloody penalty. Oh, you can't complain about it. I was trying to get the ball off his feet before he got the pass in. I'm fuming. Literally, look at him up in the air. But now, it's just got to be relied to the Scotsman to help us go for it. Substitute changes I did make before. I got to skip this. Now, May, to give them a chance straight down the middle. Hell, 3-3. This game is surely not over.
Through ball, there we go. Troy Parrott plays another one. Josh Murphy, I'm going for it. Pritchard sees the chance, back into Eliza Just. This is beautiful football from Torquay United. Oh my God, no, it hit the freaking post.
We can see a corner. 4 minutes has been added on here. Really, oh, why did it not let me be Troy Parrott? Couldn't get a header down. May lays it back into Edmonton Green. Now into Campbell. Oh my God, the stars are aligned up here. Good tackle from Troy Parrott. And you can see the wall of yellow players going for it. It's into Pritchard. Redeem himself. Oh my God, he missed it. Bloody hell. This is on a breaking edge. Oh, such a good chance. Such a good moment. And it just curled a little bit too much. It's the opposite to Roberto Carlos. 4 minutes have been played up. I think this is going to be their last chance. It's going to be kicked long from Maynard. Referee looks at his watch, blows full time. And I'll tell you what, it is literally tough. We have got to go into extra time.
Come on. All right, we've got to go in this half swinging. And we can see my left back, who I just had to bring on because I'm too scared Glover's going to get himself sent off again. Plays it across. All right, want the free kick. I want the free kick. Oh my God, I'm pressing the buttons for a freaking free kick and he's not giving it. Oh, bloody hell. Terrible pass. Terrible pass from Grievous. Lovely touch. Round my goalkeeper. Come on, what are you doing? I'm trying to call out my... This game's broken. This game is bloody broken, I swear down. I want the free kick. I pressed the buttons. I stood still wanting the bloody free kick. And you see Jordan Archer, he says, here you go, have a goal when I'm trying to tell him to rush the keeper. Broken. And yeah, at what cost? I'm losing an extra time.
All right, come on, we've got to go. Come on, Grievous. Off the bench, literally gave away the chance to giving us a lead. Through balls it into Kane. Oh, I see a great run from Elijah just to give us back. Gets in there, it's 4-4. Can you hear me now, Charlton Athletic fans? Torquay United refuse to die.
Glover holds onto the ball right here. Come on, let's just do something. Through ball, oh bloody hell, it's into Ramsey. Alright, Glover's not had the best game, I tell you what. Giving away a penalty in Hull. Oh boy. Now through balls, it lost his mark, man. Ramsey, my voice is gone to tear to pieces. Just like Charlton Athletic tearing my defence. Holds it across. Onto the free kick. Into May. Completes his hat-trick. And Heartbreak City. Oh, what's he doing? Freaking jumping in the Torquay United end. Freaking celebrate right in the front. Absolute dick move from May. As, yeah, they've taken the lead, the Addicts. Heavy touch, Campbell. I've literally gone all out. Literally, I've got everybody up forwards here. Trying to get ourselves back our lead. May, tackled, able to get rid of Pritchard. Oh no, not a terrible one. Oh, lovely work from Yamasi. Dibbles round, Campbell, oh boy. Well, that's my hopes dead and buried of hoping to get promoted to the championship next season.
And Quant touches, through balls it, lovely. Bailey, Troy Parrott, 1-on-1, come on. Well, there's still, well, no, it's not really. Well, 6-5 now. I can't even get the bloody ball. And as soon as I kick off from the spot, full time. Yeah, heartbroken. Absolute world win. Probably Wembley's best ever game, to be honest with you. Dramatic game. 6-5 it ended. But all the goals scored, we just trail short as Charlton Athletic will be going to the championship this season. The poor Torquay United. It's another season in League One. Shame. But either way, we've just got to move on from this and take this as a learning curve. All right, boys. Well, we're going to go to the top goal scorers. And looking at it right here, it is obviously Josh Murphy, out of all players, getting top goal scorers with 20. 17 for Parrott. He only came in January. 11 and 11 for Eliza Just and Jackson. With the most assists, it is actually Pritchard with 14 assists. Okay, boys, I'm just going to quickly go to the player season because this video has been dragging longer than it is. Eliza Just, I thought he was a tremendous winger, absolutely helpless in the dire moment, and someone I actually see staying for a long point of the future.
I don't think so.
You've got to be bloody kidding me. Oh, for frick's sake. Well, on that bombshell, it's going to be ending today's episode with Torquay United. Hope you enjoyed it. Absolute roller coaster. But I can't have it any other way. Stay tuned for season number 3 to fight to get into the championship. Like I said, take care, you lot. Like, subscribe. I'll see you a lot later.